Hi, I'm Christina Trauthwein. I'm the editor-in-chief of Hotel Business, and I am here right now with John Rubino, and he is the chief operating officer at GF Hotels and Resorts. Welcome.
Well, thank you, Christina. Nice to meet you.
Thanks. So, I understand you recently changed your name from GF Management to GF Hotels and Resorts. What's the reason for the name change?
That's correct. So recently we went through a rebranding, and we've always been known as GF Management or GF Hotels, and we felt that we have a rich history behind our company, been in business for 30 years, but GF Hotels and Resorts gives us the same attachment to the past experience we have, but also adding hotels and resorts to our name really tells more about what we do. We manage and we own hotels and resorts.
Okay, great. Now, talking about managing and owning hotels, I'm sure you have some plans for growth, so can you tell me about them?
We do, so we're really excited about the changes we're making. So when you think of GF Hotels and Resorts, we have several different entities. We have our entity that are the owned hotels that GF Hotels and Resorts owns through with other investors, and we also have other divisions of that. We have our asset management and consulting division, we have our third-party management, and we also have what we refer to as our turnaround properties or our bank workout properties. So we've always had this core operating piece of our business, which was the turnaround hotels. And although that will always be a piece of our business, we want to grow our third-party management. And that's exactly what we're doing right now. And we're making a commitment where we want to have skin in the game with investors, where we're willing to do sliver investments and also manage these hotels. And that's what we're going to use as our growth vehicle, along with a lot of the other great changes we're making for the company.
Okay, so company culture, I know, is very important to you. What is it about your culture that's special?
So culture is so important to us. So we're working on a lot of different programs, but we want people to feel they have a career with us. So as we grow the company and we do have plans to grow, we want to make sure that our associates can grow with us. So we're working on several different programs, whether it's mentorship programs, training programs, onboarding programs, and making sure that we're focusing on the individual, because it's the individual that really makes the company. So we want to be able to take assistant general managers and give them a program to move into a general manager role. Take a general manager and have them be able to move into a regional role. And the same thing for every level of associate throughout the hotel. You know, one thing that's important to me, I think that the strongest teams are made out of existing team members plus external talent. So we've brought in some external talent, but we're also working with the internal team members to promote them and give them the training they need to get to the next level to help our company get to the next level.
Well, you know, it's so important to develop talent, not only, you know, just to have a talented and skillful team, but also to keep that talent within your company, especially in today's climate. So
it's important, right? And it's recognizing them, and it's having them be part of the celebration. And it's also listening to their ideas, because, you know, you can sit in a corporate office and everybody at that higher level can make decisions, but when you listen to the associates from the hotel level tell you what they feel they need or what we need to do differently is really important.
So another really hot topic out there is technology.
So
how are you leveraging technology to help your company?
So what we're doing is we're giving the information about our hotels directly to the owner, so they can log into a site and they can see how their hotel is performing financially. Now, that certainly doesn't take away the need to have conversations and phone calls, but also it's making the jobs of the associates on property easier. If they have information available to them more quickly and more readily, and being more readily available, they can make decisions quicker. That can improve the hotel. It makes them be able to do their jobs more easily, and what that also does is it attracts better talent. If you have old systems and old processes and you're not listening to your associates, then you're going to always deal with the same challenges. But when you have high technology and top-notch systems, you're going to get people that want to leverage that technology to make better decisions. So I think the use of the technology that we are unveiling to our hotels now will help us attract and retain great associates.
Are you involved in community service?
Oh, that's really important too. So when we talk about aligning our values, we also talk about, you know, making sure throughout the interview process that we're truly aligned with the associates we hire. But once we get them on board, giving them the right training to keep them engaged. But what's even more important than all of that is working together as a team, not just inside the hotel, but outside the hotel. Community service is one of our focuses for 2020. And it's giving back to the communities we serve, not just where we're based in a corporate office, but the individual communities where each of our hotels is located. So it's important to us that we work together for something that's greater than just the hotel, something that's larger, that's giving back to others. You know, our philosophy is to be kind and do good.
Great. Thank you so much for your time.
Well, thank you for your time, Christina. It's nice being here.
Thank you.